John Schuster and Team USA with American curling history. They're off to play for gold for the first time ever.
Team USA and Team Canada, two ice battles, two American victories over defending Olympic champions. Hi, I'm Olivia Jaquith. In women's hockey, the U.S. finally ends Canada's decades of dominance, winning the gold medal game in an exciting shootout. And they did so on the sticks of 28-year-old twin sisters Jocelyn Lamoureux-Davidson and Monique Lamoureux-Miranda. In the third period, with Team USA down one, Monique scored her second goal of the tournament to bring the U.S. even with Team Canada. Then, after five rounds of shootout, the two teams were still tied. That's when Jocelyn unleashed a jaw-dropping move to beat Canada's goalie and deliver Team USA an Olympic gold victory. You could say the Lamoureux sisters are twinning. They combined for six goals and two assists in Pyeongchang and were involved in 41% of the team's scoring. Today, the sensational sisters helped the U.S. win its first Olympic women's hockey gold medal since 1998. For Jocelyn, it's all about teamwork.
We have this belief in our team, and shootout overtime, we knew we were gonna get it done. There was no doubt in that locker room, and we believed. And we've played this game 1,000 times in our minds over and over the last 4 years, and we didn't care how we got it done as long as we got these.
Team USA and Team Canada on the other ice today at the Curling Center. Final end comes down to the last stone. American skip John Schuster with the hammer knocks Canada's rock out of the button and the reigning Olympic champion out of the title match. It is the U.S. advancing to the gold medal game against Sweden, certain to improve upon Team USA's previous Olympic best, a bronze, won in Torino in 2006. Tyler George hopes he and his team can keep performing on the world's biggest stage.
You know what it means for somebody from the United States to do what we're doing right now, and that's why we want so badly to do it. We want it for ourselves, you know, for the team, for family, friends, but for our sport in the country. Like, this is, you know, the biggest thing that's happened in curling in our history, and, you know, to be a part of it is, it's incredible.
Another team event, this time Nordic combined, four ski jumpers who then become cross-country skiers. The Austrian team led after the ski jumping portion with a 6-second lead over Germany to start off the cross-country segment. Strong German performances in the cross-country portion helped them to make up that deficit and more. Germany takes gold by more than 52 seconds over Norway, and Austria claimed the bronze. The Germans sweep Nordic combined events in Pyeongchang, taking all three golds. Short track, men's 500 meters, China's Wu Dajing led the final from start to finish, upgrading his Sochi silver, winning the gold in world record time. This is China's first gold medal of these games. South Korea finished second and third. Still on the short track, men's 5,000 meter relay this time. Hungary had not won a Winter Olympic medal since the 1980 Lake Placid Games. Crossing the line first, they ended that drought and now also have their first Winter Olympic gold medal. They are the 29th different country to win a medal in Pyeongchang, the most ever. Now for the women's 1,000 meter short track. On the final lap, the two South Korean skaters connect and crash out. To the finish, Suzanne Schulting, in her Olympic debut, wins the Netherlands' first gold medal in short track speed skating. Biathlon women's 4x6 kilometer relay, competing in her second Olympic Games, Daria Domracheva takes Belarus across the finish line. Their first Olympic medal in this event, delivering gold. Domracheva becomes the first female biathlete to win four Olympic gold medals. Remember to tune into NBC's primetime coverage of the Winter Olympics. It's live across the country at 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 Pacific. I'm Olivia Jaquith.